Hello everybody, welcome to another very bad quality mobile video. It's just the easiest way for me to review my new air fryer, which is the, I'm gonna butcher this, sorry if I mispronounced that wrong, Smart Digital Air Fryer. This cost, I think it was about $210 Canadian on Amazon. I think it was a little bit of a savings on it, or I paid regular price, don't remember. And we're comparing this lovely, beautiful model to the T-Fal. The T-Fal I had reviewed a few weeks ago. Sorry, I'm coming out of focus there. If you were interested in that review, it's in my playlist. And if I remember, I will link that review in the description box. So there is a bit of comparisons. This T-Fal one was very close to the same price. I think my husband bought this at Canadian Tire. It was like it was over $100 for this one, maybe like $160, and that was on sale. I was not impressed with this model. It is a 4.8 quart/liter. A couple things, that reason why I didn't like it was because here, because of the way it's set up, number one, it's not digital. You can't really tell exactly what temperature. You're playing a guessing game when it comes to the temperature of this particular model. There is no holds, there's no pauses, there's no shake reminders, there's no preheat option. This machine is lacking in so many features. I have decided to keep it, and I use this as an extra. If I want to air fry chicken and fries or fish sticks and fries, I will keep this as an extra one. And it is a different, it's a circular one, so there's not as much, sorry if you're seeing a little bit of flour here. There's not a much surface area. I did purchase some accessories to go along with that T-Fal model. And those are these accessories right here. I do recommend, rather you are getting your awesome smart air fryer, a little bit of spoiler there, or the T-Fal air fryer here. This is really a good set. It cost me an additional $50, I believe, if I remember right. It comes with 10 accessories. So with the accessories, you do get that pan. Obviously, I need to reclean that. That's embarrassing. This gripper thing is actually, when you first get it, you're like, what the heck am I going to do with this? This is actually very sturdy, and it helps a lot for picking up extra, when these are hot, it picks them up. This rack is kind of useful, but not really. The idea with this one is that you're supposed to have your like fries. This is supposed to give you a little bit more cooking space. The only problem with this is that this is not that large of an area. It might look larger to you, but it's not. It's like maybe an extra 6 inches. That's what she said. Ba-da-ding. This one is officially, sorry about that, guys. This one is good. It's good for, my husband uses it for hash browns. This one is literally a throwaway item. And you got a little sticks, and you got muffin silicone things that I haven't used yet. A little bit of a bucket and a silicone mat there. So if you're able to, I would recommend, you have the extra money to spare, you'll use these accessories. Just gonna clean that. All right, now moving on to the Smart Airfryer. So this comes with its own app. This also comes with a handy little cookbook that I have used. It has a lot of recipes with specific instructions. Now, I do have the app for this one, but I also have it paired with my Alexa. A little bit of a heads up, a warning to anybody. It is very difficult to pair this and get this to work with the Alexa. I think I had to reset Wi-Fi twice, and even with that, with pairing it with the Alexa, it is not that great. I still haven't figured out how to send notifications, because this will notify you if when your food's ready, when you need to go shake it. The only thing is, Alexa does not notify you properly. You actually have more reliability being reminded by the app. You can set it so that your phone will vibrate. That's what I do to let you know, okay, get off your butt and shake the air fryer kind of thing. All right, so, but with Alexa, you can, I'm sorry I'm saying Alexa so much. I hope if you do have an Alexa, it's not like spazzing out on you right now. You can preheat and you can set options for this one. So to give you an example here, Alexa, preheat the Smart Air Fryer at 350 for 6 minutes. All right, so it went by my command. Now watch this. Alexa, turn off Smart Air Fryer. All right, so that does work. Alexa, turn on Smart Air Fryer.
Okay, at what temperature?
350. Okay, just did that as an example. So here are some of the options that you have. I'm not too concerned about this preheating. So you do have the exact temperature. This does go up to 400, maybe a bit more. I know it does go up to 400. I really like that option. I like that it has Wi-Fi. I like that you have the timer there. You do have some preset buttons here. You got steak, chicken, fish, and shrimp. You have a shake reminder, a preheat option. You have an option to keep warm, so it'll just keep it warm at a certain temperature. You can adjust your time and your temperature. That will adjust the temperature. Now, if you just want to adjust the time, you just hit the middle button. Never mind. I guess that doesn't work. I was trying to get the time. Oh, there we go. So you just have to really push it. Oh, no, push! I don't know how I did that. Okay, so it's not perfect. It does take a little bit of fiddling around with it, I guess. I managed to get it to work one time. But hey, that's embarrassing. This is the defrost button. You have fries, you have a carrot, you have bacon, you have a bake and a toast. I haven't experimented with those buttons yet, but if you do, you can pause. That'll pause it. Start again. You can put on your shake reminder sometimes. Oh, it probably is not shaking because it's under preheat. Alexa, turn off Smart Air Fryer. All right, Alexa, turn on Smart Air Fryer.
Okay, at what temperature?
310 for 3 minutes. All right, perfect. So 310, 3 minutes, that's perfect. So if you do the shake reminder, it'll remind you to shake. This did not do a preheat option because it's already preheated and I did not tell Alexa to preheat it. And then you have the option to pause. Oh, okay. So if you hit the bake button, it defaults to 300 for 35 minutes. If you hit the toast button, 320 for 8 minutes. And then you can go through all your, this will set a shake reminder for defrost. That's how long it's going to take to defrost it. Fries. That's awesome. Shrimp. Apparently shrimp only takes 370 for 6 minutes. And then you got your fish, 350 for 8. Your steak, 400 for 6. I'm not sure if that's going to give you a medium rare. Maybe. And then, of course, your chicken for 23 minutes. All right. So, Alexa, smart air fryer off. It's not going to want to do it. Okay. Alexa, turn off smart air fryer. All right. So, that is, it's very easy to read. The shake and all the options are very simple. I have mine set up just like I had my smart T-Fal fryer, or it's not smart, my extra large T-Fal fryer, on a cutting board. And that's just to kind of give it more sturdy, you know, so it doesn't burn and ruin our very cheap counters. I have it plugged into the stove. This one, the main difference is, another thing to note, this requires 1700 watts. That's why that little outlet right there doesn't work. I don't know if there's not enough wattage or it's just not set up or whatever. I'm not 100% sure, but it works being plugged into the oven. That one only takes 1400 watts. So you got 1400 watts there, 1700 watts there. I do have it where I have it so that there's plenty of space here. It's not up against the wall because you got to keep in mind that you got hot air coming out, so you want it moved away from any specific, you know, you don't want it too close or else you're going to just melt your wall, and that would not be fun. Now, for this one, there were a few reviews saying that for some people, hi, you can see me in the reflection, even though it is a little bit fingerprinty. Some people said that this is hard to remove. It's not. You got this little plastic tab here. You literally just hold on to that. And you pull it out. Now, I did just clean this. It is warm because it was under preheating. So these air fryers will warm up quickly. And we take a look. We got that coil right there. Lots of room in there. And then here is our basket. So in order to lift the basket out, you just hold the button and lift. Very easy. There is that button there, and then this is what that looks like. Yay, I cleaned it. This is what the bin looks like, and this is what the grill looks like. You obviously don't want to put this back in without having this in there. And then just hook in. So you can fit your accessories in here if you want. For this pan, you just drop it in and it's done. I'm not going to bother doing that because I do still have to clean that. All right, let's put this back in here, and there you go. All right, so it's off because I told Alexa to turn it off. This is what we have for the user manual. The model is CS358 AF series. They do have a customer service number there, and it's a smart 5.8 quart. Now, the nice thing about this user manual is that we do keep it close. It tells you the power supply, like I mentioned. I'm trying to get this into focus here. It's not wanting to focus. Very well. All right, that kind of works. So it's 17 watt, 5.8 quart or 5.5 liter, serves 3 to 5 people. It goes up to 400 Fahrenheit, which is 204 Celsius. The time range, the maximum is 60 minutes. The dimensions and the weight are there as well. And it just goes through like some safety concerns. There are little tabs that you can remove, rubber tabs. I have not removed anything. And this does give you a very kind of basic rundown of what the presets are. The control panel. Before first use, I will say you have to run this twice. You set the preheat for 400 to 5 minutes for a test run, and then you also wait for it to cool, and then you set it on the steak preset, which is 400 for 6 minutes. This is necessary because you have to make sure you do this test run. There is a mild plastic smell. I'm happy to say that it went away after the third usage, well, the first usage. So I did the test run as recommended in the book twice. First one, smell was really strong, well, not really strong enough to notice. Same with the second one, but not that strong. And then the third one, she's fine. Like, there's no additional smells. And I've used this one about, well, at least like a dozen times. I've had it for a couple weeks now. Now, this is the app I was talking about. It's called VSync App Setup. You have to set this up first before you try to set up the app Alexa app. And then there's a little code to scan. You might get frustrated. I'm just going to throw that out there. Like I said, I did eventually manage to figure it out. However, Alexa doesn't offer me all the notifications. And I've tried to go into the app. I've tried to... the Alexa app has not been offering many, like, notification options. It just, you'll understand if you get this model and you try to set it up through Alexa. It's much better to rely on the actual mobile app of the air fryer. And this does go through some preheating guides. A little bit of warning. Obviously, you don't need to add extra oil or grease to this. Number one recommendation is... I do have avocado oil. I was using light olive oil, which is all right, except this one is avocado oil. You can get it at Costco. It's the best one to get for this air fryer because it has a temperature, high heat, high smoke rate at 260. So that is pretty much a must. And I did get this one. This is the oil spray bottle. I bought this at Canadian Tire. It's a pain in the butt, but that's more of a convenience option. Basically, you spray, you want to spray your food or the little basket with olive oil before, or olive oil, avocado oil, or some high heat burning oil. Before you cook in here. So that is something, but you don't do this. I'm losing focus there. You don't put a whole bunch of oil in there because that's just going to smoke and maybe completely ruin that air fryer you invested over $200 in. And it gives you some guides on shaking the food and cooking and more features that are available on the app. Some accessories you can also buy. You can control the smart air fryer remotely. The app also offers recipes and the third-party voice control, which does not feature all the features I would like to have come from my little Echo speaker. So all in all, this 100% better than that. I do recommend this. I love this smart air fryer thing. It's like a mini conventional oven. There's just so many features that I still personally have to explore. So if I were to rate this out of 10, I would give it a 9 out of 10, losing a star just because of its compatibility with Alexa. And that might actually be more of Alexa's fault than this. It's perfect. I recommend it. Go out and get it. And 100% get that. 110% get that over that. Womp, womp, womp. All right, so this video is wrapping up at just under 20 minutes. Thanks for watching, guys, and have a good day.